We also need to see about the factors that help in this development. After we know all this, can we understand what gender stereotyping among preschool children is? So, we will first learn the factors that help in this stereotyping among kids. We will also see the effect it has on the behavior of the child. Once we know this gender stereotyping, then we will be able to understand morality among them. We will also see what the famous psychologists have said about this gender stereotyping among the children. We will also see the factors that help in the development of the morality among the children. At last, we will learn how we can inculcate moral values in these tiny kids. First and foremost, we shall understand the meaning of gender identity to understand the rest of the topic. Meaning of gender identity. Gender identity is a person's inner sense of being male or female. This identity is usually developed during early childhood as a result of parent rearing practices and societal influences. Development of gender identity. One final step in child development is gender identity and sexuality. Many people believe that sexual development does not become an important issue until puberty and adolescence. However, children begin showing sexual behavior and interest in their sexual functioning starting from infancy. Development of gender identity and sexuality cuts across physical, cognitive, social, and emotional developmental dimensions. However, just as in all channels of development, it's important to remember that each child is unique and may develop more rapidly or slowly than other children. By the age of 2 or 3, a child starts to develop a sense of being a male or female. This awareness is called gender identity. Kids at this age start to understand the difference between boys and girls. They can identify themselves as one or the other. Some people think gender identity is biologically determined and some says it is a product of child's environment. Most likely, it's a combination of both. And at this age, kids begin to associate certain behaviors called gender roles. A famous psychologist, Kohlberg's theory of gender identity development describes how young children learn to understand their gender and being what gender means in their everyday life. The famous psychologist Kohlberg was of the opinion that there are 3 stages to this process. Initially, during the early preschool years, that is at the age from 3 to 4 years, young children engage in gender labeling. Young children can tell the differences between boys and girls and will label people accordingly. However, these very young children still believe that gender can change and is not permanent. Children of this age also have trouble understanding that males and females have different body shapes. By preschool, most kids would have developed a strong sense of being a boy or a girl and continue to explore their bodies even more purposefully. As kids become curious about everything, it's common for the preschoolers to ask questions to their parents like, where do babies come from? Or why doesn't my sister have pennies? The child psychologist feels that when one gets a question like this, it is better to answer the child as honestly and matter of faculty as possible. According to them, being truthful will encourage the kids to come to the parents with their questions in the future. They also believe that some of the games that they play also help in the gender identification. One common play is the doctor game. At this stage, kids tend to be curious not only about their own bodies, but about others too. Meaning of gender stereotyping. According to the psychology glossary, gender stereotypes are fixed ideas about men's and women's traits and capabilities and how people should behave based on their gender. One example is the commonly held belief that men are better drivers than women. Develop gender stereotyping. It is believed that a great deal of how children initially learn about the world is rooted in play. According to the American Academy of Pediatrics, even before the age of 3, children are able to identify which toys and types of play. They also know which toy or play is typically associated with which gender. At this age, children also often begin choosing to play more with kids of their own gender. Society, environmental factors, and parents help the child to develop the gender identity. Society's expectation from children. Society plays a major role in the development of the gender identity. The society has fixed certain behavioral patterns which are associated with the gender from an early age. The boys are expected to be more aggressive, while the girls frequently learn to take on the stereotypical feminine qualities. Children are taught at an early age that they need to adhere to their gender traditional dress or customary mannerism. Social and environmental factors that develop gender identity. Other studies have shown that children's upbringing and social environments also has an impact on the development of gender identities. Children's interests, behaviors, and overall self-concept are strongly influenced by parental teaching. Children are taught that certain traits or activities are appropriate or inappropriate for them to engage because they are a girl or a boy. This gets stuck in the head of the child. These teachings remain with them even in later life. The role of parents. Children learn through their observation and imitation of what they see their parents doing. They tend to imitate and internalize them. They then repeat those patterns in their own lives. Children who are raised watching their parents sticking to strict gender stereotype roles are, in general, more likely to take on those roles themselves as adults. Factors that help in gender stereotyping. Gender-specific toys. Girls are typically given dolls and dishes, while boys are often given tool sets and medical kits. Stereotypical toys such as these send the message that girls need to learn to care for babies and cook, while the boys need to learn how to fix things and become doctors. Household chores. At an early age, boys are made to believe that household chores are for girls and women. It has been found that girls are generally assigned more housework than boys. The chores in a family are also gender-based. Vacuuming the floor and washing dishes are seen as girl chores, while taking out the trash and helping with the yard work is usually assigned to boys. But children raised in single-parent households may not develop as many gender-based stereotypes when it comes to housework. Since single parents have to do all the chores, children living in single-parent households learn that women and men can do the same chores. Parents as role models. Children tend to share the values, attitudes, and beliefs of their parents. They are also likely to follow their parents' footsteps in terms of careers. If parents maintain traditional gender-based careers and stereotypical roles in the household, there is a strong chance that their children will grow up with similar beliefs and carry out the same roles. Boys and girls will benefit from seeing both parents equally sharing household responsibilities. Children who witness only their mother cleaning the house will come to believe that housekeeping is a woman's responsibility. However, a woman has a career outside the home serves as a role model for her daughters. Gender myths in children's literature. Most parents begin to read to their children at an early age in order to help develop language skills and promote the value of reading. Unfortunately, many children's books are gender biased. One would have seen that male and female characters have stereotypical roles within the content of the stories. Females are often portrayed as sweet and naive, while males are portrayed as strong and independent. All the superheroes are all male in the comics. Child psychologists are of the opinion that parents should pay close attention to children's books in order to avoid selecting those that are biased. Gender stereotyping among preschool kids. It is believed that children begin to form concepts of gender beginning around the age of 2, and most children know if they are a boy or a girl by the age of 3. Between the ages of 3 and 5 years, children develop their gender identity and begin to understand what it means to be male or female. Almost immediately after becoming gender aware, children begin developing stereotypes which they apply to themselves and others. This is done as an attempt to give meaning to and gain understanding about one's own identity. Effect of gender stereotyping. Gender stereotyping is all about what is appropriate and inappropriate behavior based on gender. They are still common in today's society. Gender myths are harmful to children, parents, and society. Child psychologists are of the opinion that they need to feel free to pursue their interests and goals. Parents play a primary role in influencing their child's attitude and beliefs about gender roles. Parents should be careful about the messages they are sending. This affects their development of interpersonal and intrapersonal relationships. Children learn values, motives, and behaviors from their parents and the culture within which they live. This includes their beliefs about gender. Children who differ noticeably from the expected behavior may meet with teasing from peers and disapproval from parents or teachers or from society on the whole. Morality. Morality means principles concerning to the distinction between right and wrong or good and bad behavior. It is also called moral values. It is a fact in every society that every parent wants the child to have strong sense of morality or values. Morality is something that a child learns from a very early life. He learns the difference between rights or wrong and understands how to make the right choices as he grows up. Piaget theory of moral development. According to Piaget, preschoolers are in a stage called morality of constraint. In this stage, children tend to think of right and wrong in black and white terms. That is, an act is always right or always wrong. There are no shades of gray and there is no room to negotiate. People are good people or people are bad. Good guys are always good and bad guys are always bad. Typically, the young child will define the rightness or wrongness of an act in terms of whether or not it invoke punishment. The child is so sure that there is a punishment even if there is no one to witness the wrong. This is because the child is in the morality of constraint stage where one believes in imminent justice. Accordingly, the child might believe that she will feel and hurt her knee because she told a lie. Children in the morality of constraint stage are convinced of the nature of rules. They know that rules must not be changed. Preschoolers also tend to think about the wrongness of an act in terms of how much physical damage it has been caused. They do not consider whether or not the act was intentional or accidental. Children in Piaget's morality of constraint stage tend to look at to adult authority in a reverent manner. They tend to think that it is wrong to disobey an adult simply because that person is an adult. Kohlberg's theory of moral development. Developmental psychologist Lawrence Kohlberg built on Piaget's work to create his theory of stages of moral understanding. According to Kohlberg, young children at this age base their morality on punishment and obedience orientation. Much like Piaget, Kohlberg believed that young children behave morally because they fear authority and try to avoid punishment. In other words, little kids follow the rules because they don't want to get into trouble. However, most of them can understand the difference between good and bad behaviors. This understanding provides the basis for more complicated moral thinking in the future. Damon asserts that children generally pass through two or three of the Kohlberg stages of moral development on their way to adolescence. The first stage is fear of punishment, which is when children do the right thing because they don't want to suffer the consequences. In the second stage, children make moral decisions based on the reward concept. At this level, child cannot understand the concept of moral values. Moral reasoning is controlled by external rewards and punishments. Accordingly, the various stages and the moral concept attached to them are as follows. Stage 1. Punishment and obedience. Moral thinking is based on punishment. Children obey because adults tell them to obey. Whatever is rewarded is good, whatever is punished is bad. Stage 2. Individualism and purpose. Moral thinking is based on rewards and self-interest. Children obey when they want to obey and when it is their best interest to obey. What is right is what feels good and what is rewarding. I'll do something good for you if you do something good for me. Factors that help in the development of morality. There are many characteristics that impact the development of consciousness in a child. While both temperament and parenting have proven to be influential, there are many other factors that are often overlooked. Moral emotions. Moral emotions include feelings of guilt, empathy, and remorse. They start feeling discomfort when they are guilty. Parental discipline practices may also play a role in child's experience of guilt. Moral behaviors. Moral emotions lead to moral behaviors. They are interrelated to each other. Moral behavior is a child's ability to resist temptation, to exercise self-restraint, and to act in socially desirable ways. Parental practices that promote moral development. Most parents want what is best for their children and hope that their children develop a good moral consciousness. Unfortunately, sometimes they do not practice parenting in ways that promote consciousness development. Children pay close attention to the important people around them and they notice how people treat one another. The parents' interactions with one another and those inside and outside the family have a powerful influence. Parents have a major role in the child inculcating the moral behaviors. As the child first knows the parent, the child will always look upon the parents for guidance. Parents working together to raise their child also leads to positive consciousness development. They also found that children were more likely to internalize if both parents were using the same message of morality. How to help children develop their moral thought and action? Deal with problems appropriately. When dealing with discipline, problems determine whether the problem involves a moral issues or a social convention and deal with the situation accordingly. If a moral issue is involved, talk with the child so that the child understands the reasons why his or her actions were wrong. This helps the child to decide how to rectify the mistake. Discuss moral dilemmas. Select stories involving moral dilemmas and talk about the perspectives of the various characters. Emphasize that people make mistakes. You are not good always or always bad. Encourage children to change the rules. When playing a favorite game, encourage children to change the rules. Play the game in different ways, emphasizing that if all the players agree, it is okay to change the rules. Involve children in making some classroom rules. Emphasize what is good for the group. Avoid having children decide on punishments because they will most likely prefer harsh, unrealistic punishments that do nothing to change behavior. Encourage dramatic play and role play. Dramatic play and role play enable children to stand in another person's shoes and promote the development of perspective taking. Explore the concept of intention and motive. Use stories and puppet skits. Discuss the characters' motivations. Did Godlike try to break the little bear's chair? Why did it break? How did the little bear feel? What could be Godlike do to help little bear feel better? Prize moral behavior. Prize children for putting the needs of the group ahead of their own needs. Recognize children for being kind, fair, and helpful. Conclusion. This lesson was all about how preschoolers learn about gender stereotyping and the development of morality. We learn about the meaning of gender identity and then the meaning of gender stereotyping. We also saw the factors that affect the development of gender stereotyping. We also learned that at a very early age, kids realize that they are different from each other. The kids learn from the society, family, about these gender differences and stereotyping. The comic books and cartoons also depict boys to be the superhero with all power. They are considered strong, while the girls are depicted as being very soft and without power. They are always at the mercy of the boys. We learned that what they learn early stage with them when they grow up. Hence, this stereotyping remains with them even when they are adult. We saw that what morality is and the factors that help in the development of moral values. We also learned about the various theories regarding the development of morality. In the end, we learned how to inculcate these moral values in small kids.